Thank you. Welcome once again in our very beautiful topic, sulfurous compound. This marks the tail end of this particular topic. We will discuss the reducing actions of hydrogen sulfide. What you should not forget are those observations and explanations to what we have observed, ranging from ion 3 chloride to ion 2. That is the work of hydrogen sulfide, reducing ion 3 chloride, ion 3 ions which are yellow, to ion 2 ions which are pale green, reducing nitric 5 acid to nitrogen 4 oxide, which are observed as brown fumes. Now, we want to continue and look at some of the insoluble sulfides that are precipitated when hydrogen sulfide is passed through solutions of metal ions. This is copper 2 ions. Generally, it's supposed to be in aqueous state, and we know that copper 2 ions in possibly in aqueous state is blue in color. The moment you pass hydrogen sulfide, it is the sulfide part that combines with the copper 2 ions to form a black solid of copper 2 sulfide. And then again, if you do the same with the zinc, where a solution where there are zinc ions, it forms a white solid or white crystals of zinc 2 sulfide, which is white, white and to some extent has some yellow pigment. Ion 2 ions, which are pale green in color, you bubble hydrogen sulfide, the sulfide part reacts with the ion 2 ions to form a black ion 2 sulfide. In fact, most of the sulfides, if you look at them, are black, same for this zinc sulfide, which appears white yellow in color. We also have this lead. This lead 2 ions in aqueous state, you bubble hydrogen sulfide, the sulfide part in aqueous state will combine with the lead 2 ions to form a black lead 2 sulfide. And in fact, the last part is what we normally use to test for the presence of hydrogen sulfide, as we are going to look at in the next slide. This is the test for hydrogen sulfide. Generally, we can use moist lead ethanoate. Sometimes we call it lead acetate. Or you can use lead 2 nitrate. You soak it using a filter paper and then you place it in a gas jar full of hydrogen sulfide. There will be black. What will be formed? A black solid of lead 2 sulfide will be formed. And in fact, that's why we say the test for hydrogen sulfide, generally, if you put lead acetate paper or lead ethanoate paper or lead 2 nitrate paper soaked in, using a filter paper, and then you plunge the gas jar full of hydrogen sulfide, it turns black due to formation of lead 2 sulfide. Now, there are some points here to note. Hydrogen sulfide combines with hemoglobin. This is the reason why we say it is very poisonous. It combines with hemoglobin in the blood, and the same way as carbon 2. I said carbon 2 oxide is a silent killer. Imagine hydrogen sulfide, you can get a smell and run away because it has a rotten egg smell. Carbon 2 oxide has got no smell. Carbon 2 oxide, you cannot see it. You cannot see it, you cannot feel it. And you breathe it normally, just like oxygen, and you may think that you're breathing oxygen, could be you're just breathing carbon dioxide, and there you are. You suffocate. The same applies to hydrogen cyanide. These are very poisonous gases. Reason, they stop oxygen from reaching the cell, and that's how we say that they are poisonous. And the reason why we say that this hydrogen sulfide is also contained in eggs. Eggs contain sulfur compounds and iron. So when the eggs are boiled, the ions react with sulfur, forming ion 2 sulfide. Imagine if you keep on eating eggs, boiled eggs, a point will reach where you will be like, you want to belch like that. And the kind of smell that comes out is due to formation of this ion 2 sulfide. Nobody likes it because it is irritating. And that is the reason why it is observed as black lining of the egg. The moment the egg is boiled, you see some black lining due to formation of ion 2 sulfide. And lastly, is this compound is normally added to the cooking gas we use at home. The reason being, cooking gas may not have a smell, but the moment hydrogen sulfide is added to it, you'll be able to get the smell of the gas, particularly when there's a leak. You can get the smell because sulfur compounds generally is added to it so that you can get the smell from a distance. And that's how you'll be able to note that the gas is leaking. I promised you once again that we are going to conduct a simple experiment to show a hydration at the tail end of this particular topic. This is glucose. Glucose generally is white. All of us have seen glucose at one particular time. Now, what happens when you pour sulfuric acid on it? Allow me to pour sulfuric acid. This is concentrated sulfuric acid. Concentrated in the sense that it is 98% pure. As a density of 1.84 grams per every cubic centimeter, 18.4 molar. Very concentrated, but weak acid. I want to pour it here and leave it for some time and see exactly what is happening when you pour it in. You pour it in sugar. How does it behave with the sugar? We see that you can see the part that is now turning black. We'll give it some little time. It is turning black in the sense that sulfuric acid will be able to remove the elements of water from it. It's now turning black, you'll be able to see. And then again, once it has removed the element of water from it, what will be observed as you continue to wait for the observation, there's an element of black part you are able to see. Now I'm going to add more sulfuric acid as you wait for the observation to occur. This is concentrated sulfuric acid, and you know it has a dehydrating behavior. It dehydrates. So this is exactly what's happening. You are seeing the walls of this, it is black in color, reason being that carbon has been formed, carbon black has been formed. And as we wait to see all this, what is happening as we continue, this will mark the end of our topic, sulfurous compound. I hope and believe we'll give you questions regarding sulfurous compound. We'll be posted to you. Try to tackle every question that comes, that is brought to you before you. You'll be able to see it is boiling up, and the gas you can as well see. And this is exactly what happens, particularly when sulfuric acid is poured on you. You can see the charred black mass of carbon. Charred black mass is coming out, and some fumes. The black mass is due to formation of carbon. This is not carbon. Coming out. This is what we call a charred black mass of carbon. Look at this. This is what happens when sulfuric acid is poured to you. It removes the element of water and a charred black mass is formed. This is the effect of sulfuric acid, the dehydrating effect of sulfuric acid on sugar. This is exactly what happens in sugar, in glucose, and even in garments, like clothes. Even in your body, it removes the element of water. And there you are. It is also producing some fumes of hydrogen sulfide and sulfur. So look at this. That is it. That is it. What happens with sulfuric acid, particularly when it is reacting with sugar or any other body that can remove the element of water from it. Thank you very much. I believe you have enjoyed the lessons. And please do a bit of revision. And then we'll give you questions, try to tackle all of them. If there's any question, don't hesitate to ask us. Thank you for listening. I hope you have enjoyed. Thank you very much. See you next time.